I welcome you all for panel discussion. Going to be hot debate, but Raghav has mentioned, I'm sure going to be a hot debate. And before starting, I could start anything. I would like to thank Team Big Sigma Expo. Made this event happen successful. Actually, before coming into this show, we were wondering whether we have to make it to show or not, because you know the weekday, Tuesday and Wednesdays, you know the hardcore weekday. We were just wondering, and the moment you know I came in here yesterday and saw first day crowd was you know marvelous, and I know Raghav from quite some time. He always does his work with a passion, and I feel this proved that. So I would like to thank Big City Expo, Raghav and his team for providing this good platform for us today to do. And really they deserve a good round of applause. Yeah, I think we are running short of time, and let me start, you know, the first question the panel is. Like, you know, we are today talking about before that, I just like you to introduce the team before that. I'm sorry, I mean Hari, Bala, you can introduce yourself to the delegates.
Good morning all. My name is Bala Murugan, Executive Director for Provincial Audio Private Limited.
Good afternoon all. I am Joy Sen. I head the operations of AJ Cinemas.
Hi, I am Ranjit. I'm handling the immersive audio business in Real Image, cinema audio. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Anirvan Ghosh. I'm a director from Pulse Electronics. We are audio manufacturers.
I'm Raj Vartak, and I'm from Dolby India.
Okay, so let us start. So, the first question to the panel from my side is, as you are aware, cinema, mostly, you know, the peer will be targeting the common person who will be getting into the cinema. Our target audience is the common man. When you talk to the common man, I was just reading, you know, some magazine. So there somebody has interviewed many common people. Why do they go for a cinema? So many told that okay, the ambience nowadays is very good. Just last session we had with the architect. They create a marvelous architectural inside, and it gives you know, the good inside view. And it's all you know the pleasure to the eyes. And then some says, okay, my favorite actor. Like, you know, it may be the Kamala Hassan, they have acted, so I'm going to go there. And then some say, okay, good posh, their good seats are there, I'm going to go there. And some says, okay, that has been shot in the line, camera, photography, everything is good. So most of them talk about the visuals. So you are all, you know, basically the audio professionals. I would like to understand from you, like, how do you make people understand, you know, the whatever the new formats of audio coming into the, you know, the technologies developing nowadays. Wanted to understand what are your, you know, the steps or way ahead to improve the footfalls, not only with the visuals, with the audio. Like, how do you want to inform common person, look, okay, in this theater you have an audio from, okay, immersive sound, 5.1, whatever it is. What are your steps in giving know-how to the common man. Which will increase the footfalls to the cinema, and of course the mall owners will come. So the owner will be happy, mall owners will be happy.
Shankar-san, this question is basically for the theater owner, but anyway, I'll tell. The theater owners right now, when we actually do any immersive sound installation, we normally do is actually, one is before movie starts, we make, that is whatever the stingers that the manufacturer gives. So we actually have a religiously to do that before the movie starting and as well as at the interval. So we have that, whatever the technology is, the immersive technology is, immersive audio technology is, we used to put that stinger. And apart from that, the theater owners today, they are connected more with the social media as well. So they actually promote the kind of whatever the upgrade that they had done and what, so that's it.
True. I think I would probably take a step backward. And I would say that we are in the business of entertainment. And the lobby by an architect or a visual by a cinematographer or audio by the audio fields or the mix engineers are elements. The primary business probably is we want to entertain people and you want to do it in a manner which is where the people are moved. People want to be entertained in a manner where they feel belonging, they enjoy, they come back again, and that's our business. Basically getting people to the theater, and that has been a challenge. So it's not like audio is one part of that, a major part, because when you see a movie, we say that 50% is visual and 50% is audio. So I think it's a team which works in any cinema environment, and then it has to be communicated. And I think what we do as far as, there are many, it's not just Dolby, but idea is you create an experience where people enjoy to start with their mood, and as a result of that, those guys come back again. Because remember that all the exhibitors have a huge challenge retaining the people on the seat. People are moving away because of their palm tops, they're moving away because you have mobiles where you have very good quality picture coming to them. There they have home theaters which are improving day by day. And as a result of that, if you don't really keep improving the experience to people, then probably I don't think you can retain these things, and then you will find it economically not viable because you are then looking at a real estate and the returns that you will get from the real estate will not be good enough, and you will just lose that real estate to something else. It can be a mall, it can be an office, it can be a residential complex or anything, because finally it's a commercial world. But I think at Dolby, at least what we believe is you should have a solution which will help improve this experience on an ongoing basis, and then you sort of bring back people, and that's the mandate.
Actually, for your question, okay, being an exhibitor, I can tell you. See, after the entry of multiplex industry coming to India, all the patrons who are coming to the theater, okay, they started to viewing the experience. As if like the previous panel, what they have told, ambience, that plays a major role. Then the service, inside the service, technology plays a major role. So now you see, in the last 2 years, all the single screens have developed a lot than multiplex, which I can tell. This is because of the upgrade and the technology. So, see, a common man, he sees that only. He doesn't know what is 7.1, what is 5.1, and what is Atmos, what is DTS. But seeing coming inside, something is there. And they see, hardly 10% of the people, they do a research. Okay, they don't know what is Atmos, and they come to the box office, I want only in the Atmos screen. I want to watch the movie there only, like that. This is the mentality of a common man. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Yes.
I'll just add on to this. See, you don't need to know the technology. You don't want to know what is 4K to see a 4K movie. I'll give you an example. I have a customer who installed a system and he was listening to it and his reaction was, okay, it's good. He was not unhappy about it. And then I met him in Bombay in one of the offices, system integrator office. And suddenly he started saying, wow, you have a great system. I said, I actually was skeptical. I got a little worried because people, I mean, why he is now saying after, you know, 6 months that, wow, you have a great system. So I said, okay, what happened? He said, no, what happened is I saw the movie in my theater. And then since I came to Bombay, I saw it in a normal, one of the competition theaters. And now I understand what was different. So basically people do understand the difference, not necessarily technology, but experience is what matters. And I think that makes it work.
Yeah, taking that same point forward, it's like 50% is picture and 50% is audio. But if you look at, you know, a theater which doesn't have clear dialogue quality, people will immediately stop the show. But if the picture is running at 8 foot Lamberts, they'll still watch it. So audio is not so, I mean, such a understood subject today with the common audience, but if there's something wrong, they notice it immediately. It's a very integral part of the experience.
As Anirvan said, if the audio is not good, you will immediately get a complaint. If the picture is good, if the foot Lambert is low, still people will accept that. So that very clearly says that audio is important than picture, at least for the common man. May not be for a technician, but for the common man. That is the main cause now, as Multiplex as a big brand, where single screens are fighting against them. Improving the technology is their simple step. So I could see a lot of people coming forward. Most of the single screen owners are so passionate about picture and sound. Picture, everyone has done 2K. So instead of going to 4K, people are preferring to go for a immersive audio format, which gives them the content. Not the format matters, the content.
So, but same thing, like, you know, nowadays,
It's a comparison. You have a good picture and sound presentation in one screen, and if the next one doesn't have that, people will immediately come, because not the all the movies play at all screens, no? So people will obviously go to the next screen, watch the movie there, and they will say, oh, that is a better experience. People will immediately say, okay, that there is something special. People doesn't really understand whether it's Atmos or this thing, because Atmos as such, it has got extra surround speakers, but your stage channels, subwoofers, all remains the same. So it is a good sound quality, which is prime. A standardization of that is a prime. But adding to that, the immersive experience gives the three-dimensional experience of audio, whereas your 3D picture, this is 3D sound. So the quality is main, the first thing. And as we do the immersive audio, all the screens which is equipped with immersive audio, I can say they are standardized to the international standards or Dolby standards. So it gives the theater owner a big advantage. They invest once for the next, I can say, some 10 years or 15 years. Those equipments and those standards remain the same. Even if you see a 5.1 to Atmos, your stage channels, your investment remains the same. It is not that you have to do an additional investment for the stage channels. So people who have invested wisely are getting benefited, and those who invest wisely today will further get benefited.
See, being from a common man perspective, you know, see, everyone will what expect a clear quality. See, the, as you are telling, you are talking about the BNC great cities. They expect, I don't want any fluctuation of sound. They come, sit, I want to watch comfortability. Either it is a 5.1 or a 7.1, he will not know it. Until and then, the theater owner, he sticks the poster across this circuit and publicizes, okay, like that. So then only they will come to know, okay, this is the format, this is what, like that.
Correct. No, see, yeah, I mean, as far as communication is concerned, there are two levels of communication that we are talking about. One is the B2B, which is from the industry to the exhibition mainly, because those are the guys who are who will be actually installing. And then the communication to a wide
audience that there is something new that is happening and which is good and you should experience it. Now, I think the awareness of exhibition as far as the new immersive sound and what is happening in the world is good, and that is not necessarily the limiting factor. One of the reasons that I see so many exhibitors coming to this Cine Expo, I don't want to take away the credit from Raghav, he has done a fantastic job, but they are coming because they see a need to change and they want to understand what is happening. So awareness level of the exhibitors are good, is definitely at a much higher level. I think the challenge there is the return on investment or the viability of the investment that you're talking about. And so as a Dolby, what we are doing is we are continuously working to ensure that we bring down the overall cost, whether it is the hardware required or the changes required, how we can ensure that the total cost of the installation for an immersive solution comes down. So we keep working on that, and not really a challenge in terms of, communication. As far as B2C communication is concerned, it is more local, because if I tell you Dolby Atmos, for example, for lack of, a better example, I will not be in a position to explain. However, so if a town doesn't have that experience, it doesn't make sense to tell people that you have something called as Dolby Atmos. So typically the idea is to piggyback on the communication of the local exhibitor for that property, so that in a radius of 5 kilometer, people know there is something new, something better, and you can go and experience and then decide whether you really like it. I mean, I'm sure there will be few who will tell me it is just bloody loud. So, I mean, you can't really help it. Yeah, so that is how we look at, communicating with B2B and B2C.
Okay, one more thing. As you are aware now, the direct DTH is speaking up now. A lot of companies are launching DTH, and there also you will be getting a lot of performance and home theaters and that is also picking up. So, do you think this really is DTH of the home theater?
Being an exhibitor, I can tell, DTH and or any pirated things, hardly 30% of people go for it. But 70%, I'm talking about South, because we did a survey 2 years back. 70% of people, they come and watch the movie in the theater. And they see, many they wanted to do that only. They need to enjoy the movie with a full experience. Not just like that sitting at home. Whether the, DTH, really I'm saying, I don't know, Raj sir, don't think wrong. The Dolby Digital is coming, it is true or not, I don't know. But it is coming in front. Okay, so we can't like expect the real experience, that's what I can tell you.
See, the cinema is basically a social experience. So why do you go to movies Monday to Saturday, dad, mom leave in the morning, kids go to school, and when there is a Saturday weekend, people prefer to go for a movie for a social experience and gathering. So even you have a Atmos home theater at home, people will definitely go to a cinema to watch. So then why you should go for immersive audio is like, you have Jungle Book playing in 2D and 3D, where you will go? You'll go to a 3D hall only. You'll not go to a 2D and see. Same if the movie is playing in Atmos or any immersive audio format and a 5.1, people will prefer, they will definitely go to the immersive audio screens. And there are examples, movies which got released, big movies just come out, the collection were better in immersive screens.
70%, I'm telling you, as a patron, they will come and experience in the exhibition only. You can't experience IMAX experience in a hotel, I mean, sorry, in the home, like that.
Yeah, I think, you know, what is happening here is you have the things available to people at home was always a reality. And we should try and control that. But we should make compelling reason for people to come to cinemas. And when an architect does a lobby, that is that one compelling reason. When you go for a very high-end laser projector or a 2K or a 4K or, you know, all those things, that's the compelling reason. In audio, you go for something that they will probably not never get it at home to a large extent, to a large population. So you are differentiating the offering, and as a result of that, the concession that you do. So all those elements are basically, A, on one side you get higher ticket revenue, higher concession revenue, higher advertising because you have more people coming in. But at the same time, I think that helps people bring from, you know, I know that when Bahubali was released, people watched it on the small screen and again still came and watched it on the big screen. Because I remember a case which I don't know whether, I mean, many of you were present yesterday also. On the day it was being shown on television, the Aries Plex show was full. So people do come. I mean, it was available, right, on the television, and still people were going and watching the movie in the theater. So I think people have that requirement. Somebody who will fulfill it don't have to really worry about the I'm not saying piracy is fine. I'm saying that that is something that can be handled in two ways. One is you control piracy, and second is you make compelling reason for people to come back to the
While we talk about home theaters, the number of home theaters, people who have dedicated cinemas in their homes is still less. The major competition is people who have home theaters in their living rooms. And these immersive audio and especially these high-end formats, when it's installed in a cinema, it's done by a professional, the system is configured correctly and it's calibrated correctly, which makes a lot of difference, whereas people who put systems in their living room, they just buy something off the shelf and try to put it, and we've seen like they put surround speakers around the TV and things like that. So the experience in a cinema is definitely still going to be far more.
And the number of people who have home theaters, and those people, I don't think much people go to cinemas. The percentage will be minute, 0.05 or something. So not more than that.
Even they can't watch a serial in home theater. So my point of view is that.
The home theater, you can't get the same kind of performance what you get in the cinema theater. So. And second thing, technology is inevitable, and when you have the 5.1, 7.1, when DTS and Dolby Digital were there, at the time you had a laser disc, everything came in. And they had, at the time also, we had the same kind of a thing as well. But still, the people prefer to go to the theater only. And if you take the Dolby Atmos as a in home, it is actually meager. It will be like a 0.2 or 0.3%. It's not came to the level where in which, so once you have the full theater, this thing, it might reach at 10 or 20%.
Not even that much.
Okay, thank you.
to have certain kind of standards and rotation patterns each on the theater say that only
one. See, see what Raj told, that one is the B2B marketing. In B2B marketing, one thing is you need to make the exhibitor to feel the whatever the immersive audio is. So especially for Dolby Atmos. In Dolby Atmos, they have a clear cut. They have a bar in which they are defined very clearly in an Excel sheet. Or you just give the length, width, and height. You just key in that and what is your existing system. And so if you key in that and what the other system integrator is proposing, he can put that thing and he can see what is the DB level it should be. So it throws the entire thing. So they have a clear white paper. So I don't see they have everything.
The challenge is when we come across certain auditoriums, they are able to take up the standards and they call it as Atmos. So that is where I just want to understand how do we tackle that.
No, so we have something like Indian format Atmos as well. Making an object based to channel based. Yes, we do come across that is there.
I think there are two levels at which we need to address this. One is definitely education, and India is a market which has probably only some 2,000 screens in organized sector and maybe 7,000 screens which are owned by individuals. For anybody to reach out to such a large audience is a Herculean task. So that is something which is not, I mean, we keep doing it, but we will always be short of that type of reach. So what we are doing is, at one level, we are definitely interacting with all the system integrators to make them aware of the standards, teach them how we think it should be done, and we take their feedback as to what needs to change, and we try to incorporate as and when we need to incorporate changes in those. So A is, we are trying to ensure that people know how to design, people know how to execute, and so that they natively don't do a mistake. When you commission a screen, we are maintaining at this point of time a system where the final calibration is checked by a Dolby engineer so that the specifications are met and the calibration is right. I mean, the parameters are met. So I can definitely give vouch for the installs which are happening now, that these immersive sound solutions that they are installing with Dolby are something which is uniform and which will deliver. The problem that you are mentioning, that people will term it as something and it will not be of that standard, is not possible at this point of time, because we finally keep that control, because we believe that finally it's not about selling a product, it's about making an experience which counts. And that is something that we are very particular about. So I don't think that will be a problem going forward. I mean, see, there will be some part of the block where people will try to do something, and if we come across that, we definitely stop that. So I mean, it's not a foolproof answer I'm giving.
See, my point of view, it's all in the hands of service provider. Okay, he can't. I'm telling you, for example, for a business, they can't put a negative stand on the standards. Okay, for a Sumo auditorium, they can't give a 34 channel sound and 35 channel sound. Okay, so in that only, see, as an exhibitor, we work on budgets, we see everything, we compare apple to apple, and we do everything. So in that, if anything goes wrong, definitely, see, beyond the budget and within the budget, those things are in that situation only, everybody tends to degrade the standard. I don't want this amp, reduce this speakers, like that, this goes out.
See, as far as immersive audio is concerned, why is there a need for immersive audio at all? It's because you want to enhance the experience. So how are you going to do that? By compromising on equipment that you buy, it's not going to happen. So it's very important that when we look at immersive audio, it should be done with a intention of enhancing the experience, so you have to go for good equipment. And the push normally does not come from a system integrator side to a compromise, but it's more from the client that I have a limited budget. So in a limited budget, the first stage is to understand, do you have a good 5.1 system? Is it as good as what you heard elsewhere? And after that, if you have an appetite for increasing the experience for your customers, then we have to look at a proper immersive audio system. By trying to do shortcuts will not draw in the audience the way you want it to happen.
I would like to definitely request all the exhibition partners that if you are looking at doing something for experience, do it for experience, because otherwise you will not get the benefit out of it. So do it right will be a request to all. I mean, all of them are doing it, but anybody is trying to reduce it. Reducing is fine, unless, you know, as long as you are maintaining the things, so that you give experience and people come back to your theater. Basically, the idea is to bring people back to the seats.
When they talk about number of channels getting reduced sometime, Dolby, if you look at the design tool, there is two options. One is the minimum configuration and the another one is the recommended configuration. So the integrator can work between the minimum and the recommended, the best possible thing. So it is up to the theater owner to decide whether he can invest for the minimum requirement, but it is standard. It is as per Dolby Atmos standards or the immersive audio standards. It's not compromising, in fact. It is, the minimum is this much. If you can invest today, you start with this. Tomorrow, if you want to increase, you can go for a higher thing. So if you fall within that specification, you will get an approval also from Dolby. If you don't do that, you will not get an approval. Your theater will not get listed in the Dolby website also if you don't meet that. So that is the... It's purely technical. Dolby has come up with a standard benchmark, some tools. There is a lookup table. Choose your project. It's not that you should go for any particular brand. You can go for any brand, but it should meet the technical requirements of the design. It's basically the angle between one surround speaker to the other surround speaker. Dolby says it should be maximum, you should go to this much, say 30 degrees. You can go up to 10 degrees, so the number of speakers increases. So it's very simple, it's not confusing. But we are trying to educate the theater owners that this is the standard, this is the minimum, this is the maximum, or up to 64 also you can go for a small screen, but it's up to the theater owner if they want to invest. That's a call they take.
Basically, you have the theater owner.
Yeah, we basically take a printout, a PDF printout to the owner that your room is this, these are dimensions, this is a minimum requirement, this is a maximum recommended by Dolby, you choose it. That's it.
After digital conversion, okay, from analog to digital and the formats, everything, like lot many sound systems entered into the market. Currently, like Atmos has acquired everything. So, talking about that, as telling, you know, so all the movies are coming in Atmos, nobody. So, being an exhibitor, so we are happy, like installing Atmos, yes. Because they entered 3 years back and many players are there. But we are looking for, as an exhibitor, we were standing, okay, who is winning in this market? Then, who is giving deliverables more? So, let's execute that. That's what our opinion and everybody.
Okay,
So.
So that's why a lot of cinema wanted.
Yes. See, content deliverable is very, very important. See, just putting a Atmos and having any content is like waste. So once the content comes in that format, yes, it is work.
In fact, if you see, a minimum requirement was a 2K system for Dolby Atmos. Now we have come up with a eCinema solution also. Technically, it is possible to have, you can playback eCinema and Dolby Atmos together. We already a couple of installations where we are running Atmos with eCinema. So there are people who play a lot of regional contents like Malayalam. I play only Malayalam or I play only Telugu. I don't want to go for a 2K system. But I want to improve. The next step will be to improve the audio. How to improve? Like they have a 5.1 or 7.1 which is running. So we go to that extent. We cater to that kind of theaters also where you can play back or standardize the audio to the next level because people had come from stereo to 5.1. 5.1 to next immersive audio. And one point of our debate is whether 5.1, 7.1 or immersive audio. The concern will be the cost. Everyone want to upgrade, but the concern will be mainly on the cost. So it's like you must improve on the technology part. There is no doubt about that. People that come from eCinema to 2K or what they should improve on the sound part because people change their acoustics or change their interior finish or they can change chairs. So what is next? How to attract more people into the auditorium? So the immersive audio is the current technology in hand which is going through a change, audio part. The cost is one factor which will be of, which was of major concern because in 2012, November, December, we were doing Shivaji 3D, the first movie. People are investing on 7.1, some 10 lakhs or 12 lakhs for an average auditorium. We came and said it will cost you 40 lakhs. People, come on, what you are talking about? For that money, I will install four 7.1 systems. But the fact was like, this has got 48 channels. Even if you install 4, 7.0 will be only 32.
Do we have any standards with respect to acoustics for the apartment sound when we want to install immersive audio? Do you have standards specified like if you are going to use this immersive sound, this should be the acoustics?
You have stereo 5.1, 7.1, immersive audio, whatever, maybe your acoustics has to be same. As I told you earlier, you play a 5.1 track, your left, center, right and subwoofer is maintained at one standard level. Even in Atmos also the level is same. It's not that you have a higher level or a lower level, but acoustics, it is better to have good acoustics or better acoustics in immersive audio because you're investing on, see, acoustics is like a cinema screen for a projector and your speakers are like a projector. You project, you buy a good 4K projector and if your screen is not good, you're not going to see a good picture. So you must have good acoustics to listen to good sound which is coming from a good speakers.
But you are asking about the sound, no sir, not acoustic.
No, you will, the speakers will sound, the acoustics is better. That's why I'm just asking whether
I can tell you almost 50% of the people who install immersive audio, they ask us how good is my acoustics. So we do a reverberation study of the room and we tell them like this should be your RT60 as per, it's not a standard for immersive audio, it is a standard for playing back audio in a room for legibility, how, what should be the reverberation time of the room. So once you do the proper reverberation time, that sets the standard. It doesn't mean you need to do acoustics specially for immersive audio, but it is better because you have speakers mounted on your ceiling, which is going to throw sound onto the floor directly. So earlier days, people didn't do much of an acoustic or laying things on the floor. It's better to have that kind of little things taken care while you do an install. But basically, when you do an immersive audio, you used to rip off all your acoustics and put the speakers or in the ceiling. So people try to improve that factor also. That'll be very minimal cost. It's not going to be a huge cost, minimal cost. But if you do with the professional people like who do an acoustic design, an integrator cannot do an acoustics. A pure integrator cannot do an acoustics. There need to be a specialized team or a person who knows about acoustics, who knows about audio playback, and the guy who understands immersive audio also. They can do a better job.
The audio experience is going to be a combination of your audio system and the acoustics. So it's also very important that the person who's deploying the systems understands the acoustics and chooses the products accordingly. Because you have, you know, speakers with directivity control pattern which can be used in more challenging situations, and you can still get a good result out of it. But coming back to what Ranjit said, that they have developed a Atmos system for e-cinema, which clearly, I mean, the fact that they have had the requirement to develop that shows that cinema owners give higher priority to audio.
See, negative part, what I will tell, see, when the content is coming in an error way, so that time also, like, you can't, like, tell the acoustic. So when the content comes in a hassle way, it fluctuates. One sound travel this side, that side, so we can't help it out. So in that prospect, there is no standard. I can tell that.
Okay, that's all from my side. To audience.
Sir, my name is Jas from Kerala, Kannur.
Closer.
Can you hear?
Yeah.
See, I'm from an organized sector, not from an organized sector, as you said. I'm from the 7,000 screens in India. Can you hear me?
Just hold it closer.
Okay. I'm from Kerala, Kannur. I'm having 4 screens there. As you said, I am from an unorganized sector, not from an organized sector. See, majority of, or 50% of the unorganized theaters are ready to invest for the betterment of the theaters. But see, we are mainly getting from your vendors. Your products are getting from the vendors. And your technical people. See, we are getting information from the local engineers and your OEM people or your vendors. So there is no proper people from your end to say, this you have to do. See, if it is from a Dolby engineer is saying that this you have to do for your theater, then we can take it to ourselves that this is from a company which is manufacturing the system, we are getting this feedback. It is not from the trader. So definitely if you want to sell your system and if you want the betterment of the sound system, you have to depute your engineers. For that you should not save the money by paying the salary to them. Then only the system will come up in India. That you have to take. It's a humble request from a 4th theatre exhibitor in Kerala, Kannur, Savita Film City. Thank you.
Okay, I get your point and I appreciate what you're saying as far as having people to educate and give solutions. So, I mean, yes, I do agree that we don't have those many people. India is a very vast market. What we do is, we do have a control on what design you get from the system integrator, because please remember that a processor comes to you from us finally through some channel, and it is against approved design. It doesn't come without approved design. So you cannot get a processor unless you have a approved design for that particular location. Secondly, all the installations that happen, before installation also my engineer does get involved. So he will look at the site and advise if there is any change required. And final calibration, when he will reach, he will again check whether the angles are right and the same equipment or the equipment which will deliver are being installed or not. So we do have some checks. See, to cover a market like India and a number like 7,000 screens across India, which is maybe distributed between some 4,000 people or independents, it will be very difficult to really have those many people. And even if I have those many people, maintaining that cost, maintaining that quality across such a big, you know, number of people will also be difficult. So that is something definitely I don't think we can do. But be rest assured that we have systems in place to ensure that the quality is maintained. So that I can assure you. I hope I have answered your question.
See, sir, as you said, to keep engineers from your end, it will be an expensive issue. One suggestion, if you can go through that. See, every owner of a theater like to get an AMC, so that tuning and everything. So if your company can get an AMC for the theaters, of course you can manage the cost of these engineers by the means of AMC. So this engineers will be available for the theater people, and you will be in a position to sell your equipment very properly, and you can educate the people in a proper way. So this is the thing which your company can think, like the cost of course it is not a small amount to pay an engineer, and you won't be able to. If you depute a lump of engineers, see, many people are there, they get ready for this.
Sir, my question, have you ever approached them?
See, I have approached people through their vendors.
Okay.
Not directly. And these people are not in our vicinity. See, they are getting, see, in from South Indian Film Chamber, they can get the N number of theatre owners list. No Dolby person has called to me directly. I have approached because I like the system. Since if they want to sell a system, they know where it has to be placed. Then Dolby people can approach, like Barco and Christie is approaching with their products. And Dolby is the recognized system in the world.
Point well taken, sir.
See, this is more difficult, I'll answer for you, because in a projector, it's a complete product from the company. Whereas in a immersive audio system, there are amplifier speakers which come from different company, which are the ones which will probably give trouble over a period of time, which might not be able possible for them to fix. So ideally you should do your AMC with the system integrator who supplied the system. So he's in a position to do that for the entire system.
And we don't train the system integrator, but I mean your point is well taken. There needs to be a mechanism which is more formal so that a good service can be given to people. Point well taken. We will see how we can incorporate these things as we move forward.
Hi, I'm Pankaj Maheshwari from Movie Magic Jabalpur. I have got two questions. One, whether this Dolby Atmos system cost is going to come down in near future, and second, whether Dolby 750, CP 750 and 7.1 are same, and whether they need 750 needs to be replaced by 7.1 today.
So Pankaj, my compliments for coming all the way from Jabalpur to Chennai.
Thank you.
I think, see, it is a continuous process that we want to make it affordable to the exhibitors as far as the new generation sound is concerned. Does that mean it is going to go from 100 to 50? No, because what we did intentionally and with a very clear thought process that India is a market where the ticket is $2 and not $15 like Hollywood, and India is a market where the import duties are expensive, and India is a market where the entertainment tax is very high. So all those are realities, and we understand the importance of having the right price point. We have been maintaining a price point which is a right optimum, as I will say. Secondly, we are trying to reduce it. So there will be some reduction, but I'm sure that we are looking at that, you know, momentum play. So there will be some reduction over a period of time, but I don't think that will be so substantial that you want to really wait for that time to come. And as far as, I hope I answered your question.
Yeah, fine.
And second thing is you asked about 750 and 7.1. So 7.1 is basically a format, and 750 does that. So you can use a 750 to get a 7.1 solution in place.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Raj, on the cost part, in the initial days we had only one or two products, not the process, I'm talking about speakers and amplifiers, which were most of the people were using for Atmos. Today, if you see, there are more than 15 or 20 brands of speakers available and amplifiers available. The competition between them has cut down the cost. The processor cost cannot come down, I believe, much. But the price and the total project cost has really come down because of more number of options available
market has really become open.
I think for real image they are giving good rates, I think.
Hi, yeah. This is Kunal from Carnival Cinemas. I have two questions. First, for a layman, there's a customer who's not from a technical background. Is there a difference between 5.1 and 7.1? And the second question is, when we talk of immersive sound, I'm not talking about South where the occupancy is really, really high. Entire India leaving South, where metros and other places, ticket price is not increasing year on year by 3%. Do you think that immersive sound is only a marketing gimmick which we should play, or we will get an ROI, especially in metros, where it has already reached the threshold limit of the ticket pricing? Every person is already talking of ticket price and the occupancy percentage is not going. So just putting an immersive sound, I'll get in the competition share higher up, or will there be a genuine ROI on this?
See, as I said in the discussion, being a common man, okay, everyone are like, nowadays everything is social media and internet plays a major role, okay. So wherever you see, I'm talking about your part, wherever they see the technology is growing, people will expect that. You might be in B grade city or A grade city, okay. And when you maintain your sound level correctly itself, okay, in B grade city, they won't expect anything. But when the invention of technology comes and they publicize, definitely the footfall will be more in that only. Being a single screen or a three screen plex, definitely the change will happen.
No, I agree. I'm talking about what percentage. If we see last 4 years data of year on year leaving South, the occupancy is going up by 5%. The ticket price is not going beyond 3%. There are cinemas in metros where the ticket price is decreasing. Does that give the impact of getting the ROI on it?
Here we can't help it out because our ceiling prices is like, we have certain limitations.
So I agree, that's the reason. South is because there are multiple languages works in South.
Same thing, nowadays as a common man, he is expecting comfortability. I want to come to a plex, I need a proper service, I need a full view experience service. Okay, so he will expect everything. That is what, even if you see the, for example, you are in Carnival, you can see in Madurai or like your Pondicherry part, so many they have upgraded their, the theatres. So you can see the pulse over there. The 5% is very less. It has increased drastically.
No, I'm not talking about a particular scene, I'm talking about the entire India.
Entire India, Raj sir.
I think, Kunal, you have a valid point. See, the pricing cannot be directly linked to just one element of what you're offering on one side. Secondly, when we say that the occupancy in North is lower as compared to South, it is a slightly not so correct statement, because what happens is you are, see, the ticket price here for a best ticket price here is 120 rupees, right? Now, the ticket price in North in a city like Bombay will be anywhere upward of 250 bucks. Now, If you have say 30% occupancy in a place like Bombay, you are actually getting double occupancy because you are collecting two times more money in that sense as an exhibitor. I'm not saying you, meaning Carnival. So it has so many elements to it in terms of how you look at the total cost or the total ticket that you are charging and the occupancy that you are getting. A more valid reason for doing a immersive audio will be to check whether what you were doing historically in the place and how it changes when you change something. It can be 4K, it can be immersive audio, whatever, and what is the return on investment. But there is still a catch, because you will have a Sultan coming in a month and you can't have a Sultan coming again, and then you can't really have the comparison. So what I feel is, finally it will have to be a gut feel or some sort of analysis at the exhibitor end, where a organized player like you will probably do it like this, and that is how most of them have done, that you do few screens, see what is the response, anything that you do. And then you probably come to a conclusion, yes, this expense makes sense, or it doesn't give me something back. Our experience has been with many single screens, because that's where the numbers are more transparent to us, because the data gets lost when it is a chain. What we have seen, and I can share with you, is there are cases where we have seen a distinct improvement when they did certain improvements in audio, in seating, in video. But audio, because I know I was involved in those cases. So we have seen things happening. We have seen cases, especially in single screen, that you change the upgrade the thing and you are getting better benefits. But there is again a catch that you need to remember. When we are talking about single screens, these are large audis and they have capacity to sell. So if the additional occupancy is there, that is available. So, it's a combination. I'm not answering your question, but I'm just sort of making it a little more clearer.
So exactly my thing is how 3D is a need of art in today. Is the time came where a common customer knows which is the forthcoming movie in Atmos? He definitely knows which is a 3D movie. He will, if you'll go and ask him which is the next 3D movie, he'll tell you that is the thing. But does he knows which is the next Atmos movie? Has the time come in that?
I think, I'm sorry to interrupt, we are running short.
Not a problem, we'll take offline.
Yeah, you can please take offline with him. He's available to take here.
Sure.
Any more questions?
Thank you. My name is Suno. I am a consultant, brand consultant for exhibitors. See, one of the things happening in India is the evolution of the telecommunication technology and the 4G on LTE, and the claim to get into the homes through 4G LTE, and the next Sultan is coming to a screen on a smartphone or a smart device. So it appears to me in the context of looking at the market, you guys sitting on the dais are really in a strong position compared to the theater owners, because as an observer, as a consultant, I think the sellers have got the power, and the theater owners seem to be at the mercy. I mean, because they may have to go through different steps or intermediaries to get to you, to get the service. But with this happening, how are you going to support the theater owners? Because it's your bread and butter also. If Reliance Jio is going to pump the content, that is the new Sultan, and he can also control the content before it comes to the movie theaters, how are you going to address that? By working in partnership with the screen owner. Thank you.
I will not agree with what you said. I wish we were in that controlling position. We are not, I can tell you. I think all of us here view exhibitors as a partner, because we are not there. We can't reach the audience unless we have that last link. It's a chain, right? From content creation to exhibition. And I think because all these avenues will be available, if the exhibition industry has to survive, which if it doesn't survive, we will not exist. So if the exhibition has to survive and flourish, then probably we need to work more closely. And we do that. I mean, as a company, I can say that we do that. The mandate is not really to just do some business, because I can tell you that we incur a lot of cost doing this, and it's not really what you think, that we are in a controlling position. So I think yes, it has to be a joint thing, and these type of forums help us to reach out to people, and we will be in a position to cement that better. We empower the partners so that they can help better and make the experience better, so that people come back to the theater. That's the way we look at it.
Discussion. Thank you, my family, for spending time here and valuable time and sharing your knowledge. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, gentlemen. Can I request Mr. Udeep, CEO of Mayajal, to kindly come forward and present our panelists and our moderator with a small token of appreciation. I request the gentleman to kindly stay back. Just 2 more minutes. We have a small little token of our appreciation. Can I request Mr. Udeep to present Mr. Sankarshan, Director, Technical Sonics, with a momento? Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause. I request Mr. Udeep to present Mr. Ranjit S. Nair, Domain Manager, Immersive Audio, Real Image Media Technologies, with a momento. Followed by Mr. Raj Vartak, Head Cinema Sales and Content Services, Dolby Labs. I also request him to present Mr. Anirvan Ghosh, Mr. R.P. Balamurugan, and Mr. Jayson Kumar. The token for appreciation. I can see a lot of you leaving the hall. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to quickly continue with our next session. There's going to be no break, so kindly do not leave the hall. We're just going to jump into our next presentation. So there's going to be no break. Thank you so much, gentlemen.